Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to do object tracking using YOLO V8. So we are going to detect objects and track objects on a video exactly like that using 100% YOLO V8 entirely. We are not going to use any additional object tracking library like Sort or Deep Sort, but we are going to solve the entire problem using only YOLO V8. And now, let's get started. And now let's go to PyCharm and let's create a new PyCharm project. So I am going to File, New Project, and I am going to select the directory where I am going to create this project, which in my case is somewhere around here. I'm going to press OK, and I am going to create this new project using a virtual environment with Python 3.8. I click on Create, and then Create from Existing Sources. Now the project has been created, and now let's install the requirements we need in order to work on this tutorial. I'm going to click on File, Settings, then Project, Project Interpreter. I'm going to click this plus button over here, and I'm going to search for Ultralytics. That's the package we need in order to work on today's tutorial, Ultralytics install package, and that's pretty much all. This is going to take a few minutes, but in the meanwhile, we can continue working on this tutorial. So I'm going to click on OK. Remember, we are still installing this package, Ultralytics. This is going to take a few minutes, but in the meanwhile, let's continue. I'm going to create a new file. So I'm going to File, New Python File, and I'm going to call this file main.py, and this is where we are going to work, this is where we are going to code the entire pipeline of this project. And the first thing I'm going to do is to write all the steps we are going to take in order to complete this project. So the first one is to load the YOLO V8 model we need in order to detect objects and in order to track objects, right? In order to do the object detection and the object tracking. Then we are going to load the video we are going to use in order to test this pipeline, right? And then we are going to read frames from the video. Then we are going to apply the object detection. We are going to detect objects. We are going to track objects. Then we are going to plot the results. And then we are going to visualize, right? So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 steps we will take in order to complete this project. Now let's get started over here. I am going to start importing Ultralytics. So from Ultralytics, import YOLO. And now I am going to start with the first step in this process, which is loading the YOLO V8 model we will use in order to do the object detection and the object tracking. And this is how I'm going to do. I'm going to define a new variable, which is model, and model will be YOLO. And I'm going to use the YOLO V8 nano model. So that's pretty much all. Now we have defined the model we will be using today. Now let's load the video, and let me show you the video we will be using in order to test this project. So I am going to the directory where I have created this project, which is over here, and this is the model, this is the video we will be using, right? This is the same video I showed you during the intro, right? This is the video we will be using in order to test this object detection and the object tracking. You can see we have two dogs and a person, and we will track these two dogs and the person through all the frames of this video. As we are going to use a pre-trained model from YOLO V8, these are all the classes we are able to detect with this model, right? We are going to use a model which was trained on the COCO dataset, and these are all the classes we can detect. We can detect person, bicycle, car, motorcycle, airplane, bus, and so on. We can detect up to 80 different classes with the model we are going to use. And you can see one of these classes, one of the objects we are able to detect with this model is person, and our class is dog, right? And if I show you the video again, we have exactly two dogs and a person and nothing else, right? These are the only objects we have in this video. So this pre-trained model, which was trained on the COCO dataset, is going to be just fine in order to detect and track these objects. Now let's continue. So the loading the video will be something like this. I'm going to define a new variable, which is video path, and this will be the current directory, and it's called test.mp4, right?
I am loading this video over here, which is called test.mp4. Then I am going to import from, I am going to import CV2, and I'm going to load the video like this, CV2, video capture, and then video path. And that's pretty much all. Now let's start reading the frames from the video. And I'm going to define another variable, which is red, and I'm going to initialize red as true. Now I am going to do something like this. While red, I am going to read a new frame from the video like this. Red frame equal to, this is going to be equal to cap equal to CV2, video capture, and the video path, and this is going to be cap.read, right? So this is how we are going to read a new frame from the video. We are going to call cap, which is this object we have defined over here, right? This is the video we are loading, and we are going to call this function, this method, which is called read, and this is going to return a new frame from the video, and it's also going to return this variable, which is a boolean variable, which is going to be true if we were able to read a new frame successfully, and it's going to be false in any other case. So that's exactly why we are doing a while read, because once we reach the end of this video, once we have reached the last frame from this video, then this is going to be false, and we are just going to get out of this while read, right? This is exactly why we are doing it like this. Now let's continue. Now we have read a new frame, and now let's continue to the next step, which is detecting objects. And the way this works, the way YOLOv8 works in order to detect objects and in order to track objects, we are going to do these two steps at once, right? We are going to detect objects and track objects with only one sentence, and let me show you. So we are going to do these two steps at once, and we are going to call model.track, and we are going to input the frame, and we're also going to input another variable, which is persist equal true, right? Because we want YOLOv8 to be able to remember all the objects it has seen through all the frames in the video. So it's very important we define this persist equal true. This is very, very, very important. And we are almost there. This is going to be results, and now we can continue to the next step, which is plotting the results. You can see how fast we are going. You can see how straightforward this process is. This is amazing. And now let's move to the next step, which is plot results. This is where we are going to take the frame, and we are going to draw a bounding box in all the objects we have detected, and also this is where we are going to draw all the results we got from the object tracking. And this is how we are going to do that. I'm going to define another variable, which is frame underscore, and this is going to be results 0, because we are detecting all the objects and we are doing all the object tracking in only one frame, so we are going to access the first element from the results, and then we are going to call plot. And that's it. That's the only thing we have to do in order to do this plotting. Now let's continue to the next step, which is the visualization. Later on, in a few minutes, I'm going to show you another way in which we could also do this plotting, but for now let's just continue, because this is a very, very, very easy and a very straightforward way to do the plotting. Now let's continue to the visualization. And this is how we're going to do. We're going to call CV2 imshow, and we are going to define this window something like frame, and then we are going to plot frame underscore, right? And then we are going to call CV2 wait key, and this is going to be something like 25 milliseconds. We are going to wait for 25 milliseconds, and we are going to exit, we are going to quit this visualization by pressing the letter Q. And this is how we need to write it, something like, this is going to be equal to ord Q, right? And this is going to be break, and this is obviously an if. Okay, if this situation, then break. So basically this is how we are going to tell this software that if we press the letter Q, we want to quit, right? We want to exit this loop. So this is pretty much all. And now the only thing I'm going to do is to press play. And let's see what happens. I'm going to run main. Okay, we got an error because this is not YOLOv8n.py, but this is .pt, right? I made a mistake. Now let's try again. Okay, and now everything seems to be working just fine. You can see that we are detecting all the objects in this video, and we're also tracking the objects, right? In this case, this is the object with the ID number 1, this is the ID number 2, this is the ID number 3, and you can see that across all the frames in this video, this object remains as the ID number 1, this other one as the ID number 2, this other one as the ID number 3, so that means the object tracking is working just fine, it's working perfectly. So, this is going to be pretty much all. I'm going to quit by pressing the letter Q, and that's pretty much all. The only thing we could do in order to make it even better is to do something like this. I'm going to do here, after we read the frame, I'm going to do if read, then continue, right? Because remember, we are reading frames from the video, and once we have reached the end, once we have absolutely no frames left, this is going to be false and this is going to be none, right? So we definitely do not want to continue if this is false. So this is how we are going to do it. Now, remember, I told you there was another way in which we could do the plotting, and this other way involves using cb2.rectangle and cb2.putText. By using these two functions, you should be able to achieve exactly the same visualization as we got over here. And if you want to know exactly how, you can use these functions in order to draw bounding boxes on top of a frame, and in order to draw text on top of a frame, I invite you to watch other of my previous videos where I show you a fully comprehensive course of OpenCV with Python. And one of the lessons in this course was about drawing. So by watching that lesson, you should be able to use these two functions in order to achieve exactly the same visualization we got over here. So this is going to be all for today. This is exactly how you can do object detection and object tracking using YOLOv8 entirely, using 100% YOLOv8, and this is going to be all for today. My name is Felipe, I'm a computer vision engineer, and these are exactly the type of videos and the type of tutorials I make in this channel. If you enjoyed this video, I invite you to click the like button, and I also invite you to subscribe to my channel. This is going to be all for today, and see you on my next video.